Hey yo, what's poppin', my fellow music lovers and listeners? Welcome back to Multifaceted Media Entertainment. And today we're gonna be talking about some controversial tweets that Nicki Minaj made over the past few days. And everybody seems to be up her ass about it, so I thought I'd talk about it today. Alright, so these tweets are in relation to her not attending the 2021 Met Gala and her reasoning for not doing so, which, as she states in this tweet, the Met Gala requires for all its attendees to be vaccinated. And as she states here, she's not willing to do that until she has done enough research. And apparently she doesn't feel like the Met Gala is a worthy enough cause for her to run to get vaccinated. All right, so the tweet reads, "They want you to get vaccinated for the Met. If I get vaccinated, it won't be for the Met. It will be once I've done enough research. I'm working on that now. In the meantime, my loves, be safe. Wear the mask with two strings that grips your head and face, not that loose one." Alright, so largely don't have a problem with what Nicki Minaj said here in general. Really, my only issue lies with the fact that she said if she gets vaccinated, it will be once she's done enough research. And the only reason I have an issue with that is the vaccines have been out for what, like 2 months shy of a year now? I think they've been out since November last year. And this virus has been running rampant across the globe for almost 2 years now. We've seen what it can do. We've seen what it has done. So I'm just wondering why it has taken international superstar Nicki Minaj this long to do research on something that's been out for so many months now. And I'm also curious as to what she's trying to find out at this point. This long after the vaccines have been out, I'm just curious as to what she's hoping to find out that wouldn't be necessarily widely publicized if it had some extreme negative effects. And of course, I'm not against the prospect of her wanting to do research. I mean, do your research, of course. I'm just wondering why the hell it took you so long. But I guess what I'm trying to say here is I think if Nicki Minaj was truly interested in getting vaccinated from the get-go, she would have done her research quite a few months ago. And she would have gathered enough information by now to have a firm stance on whether or not she wanted to get vaccinated. But there was also this other tweet, and I think this is the one that stirred up the most controversy, and rightfully so. But this tweet reads, "My cousin in Trinidad won't get the vaccine because his friend got it and became impotent. His testicles became swollen. His friend was weeks away from getting married. Now the girl called off the wedding. So just pray on it and make sure you're comfortable with the decision, not bullied." Alright, so some major issues with this one. First of which being the use of anecdotal evidence. As a matter of fact, I don't even like calling it anecdotal evidence because I really don't think personal anecdotes should be used as evidence in the first place. But yeah, my first issue lies here with Nicki Minaj bringing in her personal anecdotes to influence the decision making of her millions of fans. Because even though she doesn't explicitly say, it's pretty clear here that what she wants to be inferred is that her cousin's friend didn't only get the swollen testicles subsequent to taking the vaccine, but you know, as a direct result of taking the vaccine, which she cannot know if that's the case. In fact, I'm almost sure that's not the case, because first and foremost, you have to take into consideration the fact that correlation does not imply causation. Just because I walked a portion of my journey home in the rain yesterday and then woke up with the flu in the next morning doesn't mean that the rain necessarily is the reason for me getting sick. Because I could have just as easily had sat beside someone in the taxi who had the flu and contracted the virus that way. So I'm saying this to say, until there is sufficient evidence that one thing happened as a direct result of another thing, then it shouldn't be implied under any circumstance that one thing is a direct result of the other. And because Nicki Minaj has such a large and vast fan base, she really has to be responsible with the information that she tries to convey. And then Nicki Minaj goes on to say, just pray on it and make sure that you're comfortable with the decision you're making and that you're not being bullied into taking the vaccine. Which I found weird, because I mean, if you're praying on it, then why would you need to make sure that you're comfortable with the decision that you're making? I mean, certainly God should answer a question of this importance, of this magnitude. So I'm pretty sure that once your prayers have been answered, you would do whatever God wants you to do, irrespective of whatever you're comfortable with. But what do I know? But I don't really blame Nicki Minaj's hesitance to take the vaccine or her ignorance about the vaccine solely on her. Because I really do think the healthcare system has done a piss poor job at, you know, kind of informing the masses as to how the vaccine works and what it does, which kind of leaves a lot of room for speculations, a lot of conspiracies, a lot of fear-mongering, which in the long run is only going to be counterproductive as it relates to keeping this goddamn thing under control. But we also got to take into consideration the possibility that Nicki Minaj's cousin's friend did become impotent as a direct result of taking the vaccine. But we got to look at it this way. There are billions of people in the world with billions of tiny variations as it relates to their physiology. So there will most definitely be a few people that react quite differently than the majority after taking the vaccine. I mean, a lot of people even have a lot of underlying illnesses that they don't even know about, that they aren't even aware of. I mean, how many of you have visited the doctor recently to do a checkup? How many of you? Exactly, and this is why it is recommended that you do a checkup before taking the vaccine, so that your doctor can advise you towards or against it for whatever reason. But then again, you just have to weigh your odds here, because if the vaccine has any chance of killing you, what do you think is going to happen to you if you catch COVID? I also saw some people making fun of the fact that Nicki Minaj was comfortable getting ass shots, but not comfortable to take the vaccine. Which I found absolutely hilarious, because yes, there are definitely much more documented cases of those kind of injections having, you know, adverse side effects. But yet she was comfortable with getting those shots, even though that was purely for aesthetic purposes. Purely and solely for the purpose of her looking and feeling more appealing and attractive. But when it comes down to taking a shot that could potentially preserve her and her family's health, nah, that's too far. That's where she draws the line. But let's look at it this way. Maybe if she was to take the shots now, she wouldn't have done it. Maybe she's grown since then, because she did take those shots quite a long time ago. So who knows, maybe if she hadn't taken it then, maybe given the mind state that she's in now that makes her so skeptical to taking the vaccine, maybe she wouldn't have taken those shots now either. Even though I highly, highly doubt that that's the case. But if it isn't the case, then that's some serious case of cognitive dissonance there. But yeah, guys, I hope that Nicki Minaj's research proves helpful and feeds her with the right information. I hope she ends up making the right decision, whatever that is. But I think she needs to remind herself of the fact that she has a vastly large fan base and she's not a health professional. So I think she needs to be more responsible with some of the messages she tries to convey. And it's not only what she said, but you know, how she said it and what she's implying within these tweets here. But yeah, those are my thoughts on this whole issue. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Also, hit the like button, the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you get notified whenever a new video drops on the channel. Once again, this has been Multifaceted Media, and I'm signing out.